The HDD job site is made up of two separate work areas, one at each end of the crossing. The rig side, where most of our equipment is placed, and the pipe side, where the pipe string is assembled and eventually pulled through to the rig side. Here's a typical setup for the rig side. Power for all of our equipment is completely self-contained. Sometimes, the HDD borehole is partially enclosed in a surface casing to stabilize overburdened soil and to protect the surrounding natural resources. The casing can also be used as a conduit for the utility line installation. We may also erect specially designed sound mitigation barriers around the worksite when we're working in noise-sensitive areas. If space is limited, our typical setup can be safely modified to make the work area more compact. After the equipment is positioned and tested for safe operation, the first step is to bore a pilot hole. We measure the orientation and location of the drill bit using a magnetic guidance system. Magnetic and gravitational sensors read the direction, angle, and velocity of the bit along three axes. This information is fed back to monitoring equipment in the control trailer, allowing our operators to precisely steer the drill stem and plot its path. As more sections of drill pipe are added, a pre-calculated curve is drilled. This curve, or build-up rate, is maintained to follow the design drill path from entrance to exit. On extremely long crossings, our leading-edge technology allows us to drill from both sides of the bore, precisely intersecting at a pre-designated point near the middle of the drill path. During the drilling process, we use a drilling medium called bentonite, an environmentally safe organic powdered clay. The clay is mixed with water, pumped through the drill stem, and injected ahead of the pilot bit to help clear the way, provide lubrication, and carry material back to the mud rig. Our fluid maintenance equipment cleans and recycles the drilling fluid. After the pilot hole is bored, the next step is to attach hole enlarging reamers to the drill string. The reamers are rotated and pulled or pushed through to enlarge the hole sufficiently for smooth pullback of the pipe. Depending on the diameter of the utility, we may need to ream the hole several times using a larger reamer with each pass. After reaming is complete, we prepare the utility line and couple it to a lead reamer and swivel. The line is then carefully pulled back to the rig side as sections of drill pipe are removed. During pullback, the travel and position of the pipe string is closely monitored. The result? An environmentally and structurally sound utility crossing that often takes days instead of weeks to complete.